Hallo, guten Morgen, guten Tag, guten Abend. So basically the greeting depends upon at what time you are watching this video. So today we are going to see how are we going to use two objects in one sentence. A very interesting thing about German language, it is to use two objects in one sentence without using any preposition, without using any connector, for example. And for that, we have the cases. When we hear the cases, the name of cases, we really get scared. But it's not that difficult. You just need to get the technique correct and then you're equipped with it. Okay, so let's see how many cases we have already learned. Of course, we have learned three cases till now and fourth one as well. Nominative, accusative, dative, and genitive. But genitive we have done only with the names, like Aboli's Brille, for example, Samruddhi's book, Aniruddha's Handy, for example, right? So that way we have done the genitive one. But today we'll focus on the first three cases. Nominative, accusative, and dative. I personally love these cases and I really enjoy making the use of them. So do start enjoying what you are making, what you are learning. Only then this fear of using nominative, accusative, dative, or when we hear these three names, they really fall on us like bombs. But they are not that difficult. You just get the technique, like I said. So for example, I'll share my screen with you and we'll see some of the examples. So, zum Beispiel, ich schlafe. First, I'll write all the sentences with ich. Ich schlafe. I need to change the language. Okay. Ja, ich schlafe, ich zum Beispiel trinke Milch mit Honig, dann ich gehe spazieren. Was mache ich danach? Ich esse eine Suppe. Und die Suppe gefällt mir sehr. Ich helfe meiner Mutter beim Kochen. Okay, so these are a bunch of sentences. So let's analyze them first. I don't like this. I don't like the right marks on my text. Okay. Ah, the spelling is wrong. Schlafen. Schlafe. Yeah, now it's correct. Also ich schlafe, ich trinke Milch mit Honig, ich gehe spazieren, ich esse eine Suppe, die Suppe gefällt mir sehr und ich helfe meiner Mutter beim Kochen. So everywhere now we have something as subject and something as object, not in all sentences. For example, ich schlafe, what we have? We have the nominative subject and the sentence is complete because schlafen is something, is some act where you need just the subject. You don't need an object. Okay. If you wish to add, for example, ich schlafe bis spät. Okay, until late, for example. But this is a different thing. This is not an object. You are just describing the activity of schlafen in depth, in detail. Ich trinke Milch mit Honig. Now here, for example, or let's take this sentence up. Ich gehe spazieren. Here also, ich is the only subject we have. Gehe spazieren, spazieren gehen, separable verb we have used. Gehen is conjugated and spazieren we use at the end of the sentence. Here also, for example, if you wish to add something, then it will be ich gehe jeden Morgen spazieren, for example. Every morning I go for a walk. I take a walk. Ich gehe jeden Morgen spazieren. Ich trinke Milch mit Honig. Now here, jeden Morgen, we can also discuss, of course. Ich trinke Milch mit Honig. Ich esse eine Suppe. Die Suppe gefällt mir sehr. Ich helfe meiner Mutter beim Kochen. Okay, so here again, we have ich as our subject every time. That is pretty clear to you already. Right? And then, what is the rest of the sentence? Now, Milch mit Honig or eine Suppe. Now, what are these? Milch mit Honig, eine Suppe, meiner Mutter. What's that? Milch mit Honig then is our object. Correct? So, like you say, I have a pen. I have something. That something will always be our object. I have a book. I have a laptop. Okay. I have a German tutor, for example. So German tutor will be your object. And you are the subject because you have it. The one who does, the one who has is the subject of the sentence always. The doer, what we call it, right? Subject is always the doer. It's the active one in the sentence. Because according to subject, we conjugate the verb. And verb is the action, correct? So who does the action? The doer does the action. So the doer is our subject. That's clear? Now, let's move on to the second part of the sentence. Like we said, this spät is just you are describing activity of schlafen in detail. Jeden Morgen, here also you are describing activity of spazieren gehen in detail, but since Morgen is a noun, jeden Morgen, of course, will take accusative case. Because before verb, if the subject comes, or after verb, for example, if you start this same sentence with jeden Morgen gehe ich spazieren. Here also, who does the action? Who is going for a walk? I am. So ich is going to be our subject once again. Yeah, it doesn't matter whether ich comes or the subject comes before the verb or after the verb. That's the beauty of the German sentence. You keep verb at position two, and then you keep changing other words, places logically. Okay, now you cannot say spazieren gehe ich jeden Morgen. You can actually. That's also a beautiful sentence. But it sounds very poetic. We do not say that in colloquial language. So jeden Morgen gehe ich spazieren. Still, the subject will be the doer only. The subject will be the active thing or the active person or the active subject. Okay, let's call it a subject. And then ich trinke Milch mit Honig. So here, what am I drinking? Is my object. Milch mit Honig is my object. Ich esse eine Suppe. What am I eating? A soup. Ich esse eine Suppe. Die Suppe is my object. Eine Suppe is my object. Die Suppe gefällt mir. Now here we have a different kind of sentence because here we do not have, okay, let me just type first the case of it. Akkusativ. And the Suche is also Akkusativ. Richtig. Ich, every time we have taken the same subject, just die Suche is a different one. Gefallen, the verb takes, dative, direct dative. It doesn't take accusative at all. What is the need of gefallen? Nominative and direct dative. In between, we are not using accusative at all. Die Suppe gefällt mir sehr, for example. So, die Suppe becomes the subject. Just like, for example, in Sanskrit, we say, Ganeshaya Modakaha Rochante. Ganeshaya Modakaha. Ganesha like Modak, for example. So, the one who likes it is going to be in dative case. The one who likes it. I like it, so I will be in dative. That's why here comes mir. Oh, sorry. That's why here comes mir as the dative. The super gefällt mir sehr. So there is a certain number of such verbs who take direct dative, like danken, gratulieren. So it's ich gratuliere dir. Direct dative. Gefallen is a bit different because the one who likes it is in dative. Otherwise, gratulieren, danken, dann was haben wir noch? For example, oh, das fällt mir nicht ein. Okay, these two words definitely. And then passen und dann stehen. For example, das T-Shirt steht dir gut oder das T-Shirt passt dir gut. These verbs take direct dative. They do not take accusative at all. Nominative, verb, dative. Okay. Ich helfe meiner Mutter. Helfen is another one. For example, you help someone. So that someone is going to be in dative. Okay. Ich helfe meiner Mutter beim Kochen. Then beim Kochen is a prepositional clause. Beim Kochen. Like you're helping with what? You're helping for what? Ich helfe meiner Mutter. Again, meiner Mutter will be dative. Okay, it's going to be dative. So the red one I have marked in dative. Now what we are going to do. So till here we have already learned. So this was just a quick revision of it. Now what we are going to do, we are going to take two objects in one sentence. For example, meine Mutter gibt mir Schokolade. Meine Mutter gibt mir Schokolade. Or let's not take ich. Die Lehrer empfehlen uns einen interessanten Film. Die Lehrer empfehlen uns einen interessanten Film. Or, for example, meine Eltern und meine Großeltern schenken allen Verwandten ihre Lieblingssachen zu Weihnachten, for example. Okay, so let's take these three sentences now as our examples. Meine Mutter gibt mir Schokolade. A little longer sentence. Die Lehrer empfehlen uns einen interessanten Film. Meine Eltern und meine Großeltern schenken allen Verwandten ihre Lieblingsgeschenke oder Lieblingssachen zu Weihnachten. Okay, so every time now I have taken a different subject and we have two objects. Now, what is your, let's say, what is your trick to get the cases? You always first locate the verb. That is very basic and a very basic step to do because that is very simple as well. Now, we say that German verb is always at position two, then it is not difficult to locate the verb. So, let's locate the verbs. Gibt, empfehlen, schenken. Okay, gibt, empfehlen, schenken. So, these are the three verbs, for example. Meine Mutter gibt mir Schokolade. Die Lehrer empfehlen uns einen interessanten Film. Meine Eltern und meine Großeltern schenken allen Verwandten ihre Lieblingssachen zu Weihnachten. So, now you have located the verb. Ask questions. I think that's the most difficult thing. Many of the German learners find it difficult because we rarely ask questions. So now this is your chance. Ask questions to the verb. Okay, and verb has to answer. If verb doesn't answer, if verb doesn't satisfy your question, if you don't get a satisfactory answer, let me put it in other way, other words, then you don't have that case. Then you are not using a particular case, for example. Now, our first rule, what is the subject? The doer is the subject. The active one is the subject. Who is active in each sentence? Meine Mutter. So, for example, you need to ask first question is who? Who gives? Who suggests? Recommends? Who gifts? Here, meine Mutter gibt. Also, my mother gives. So, meine Mutter is going to be our subject. Okay? Meine Mutter gibt mir Schokolade. Now here, who is recommending you film? Die Lehrer. Also die Lehrer will be our subject. Klar? Meine Eltern und meine Großeltern schenken. Again, who is gifting? Dem. These people are gifting. So all of like this block will be our nominative case. Okay, this block will be our subject. So now what you have? A subject block in each sentence. Right? A subject block in each sentence. Let's put it as a bracket. So you have a block, proper block. Oh, sorry. Yeah, meine Mutter, die Lehrer, meine Eltern, meine Großeltern. This is now going to be your subject. Pretty clear? Subject is easy to find? Yes. Now let's concentrate on the rest of the sentence. Now you ask, what? What is happening? What is given? What is recommended? What is gifted? Schokolade. Einen interessanten Film. And ihre Lieblingssachen. Correct? So first question we asked was who, and we got answer as our nominative subject. Subject, yeah. Now we are asking what, and we are getting answer as accusative object, or let's call it a direct object. A direct object. Okay, who? Okay, now I have changed the language to German, so that's fine. Okay, so who, nominative subject, what, accusative object. So what is given to me? Let's select green. Schokolade, einen interessanten Film ihrer Lieblingssache. This is going to be now the accusative subject. Okay. Now, what remains? In first two sentences, just one word more. In last sentence, we have something else as well. So first concentrate on first two sentences. Now, whom are you giving it? Whom is the mother giving? Whom are the teachers suggesting or recommending a film? To us, to me. So me or us is going to be our dative object. So instead of using to me, to us, this to we are not using in German. Direct dative. We have the direct case. We don't need a preposition at all. Okay. So here, mir becomes dative indirect object. For example, here we have allen Verwandten. To whom? Whom are you giving? So here haben wir whom as dative object, or we call it an indirect object. Okay. Also, now we have all three cases. And now, zu Weihnachten, that's additional once again. Okay, it takes zu Weihnachten as for Christmas. In English, we would say for, but in German, we'll say zu, to any festival. Zu Diwali, zu Weihnachten, zum Geburtstag, for example. Zu Weihnachten, okay, for Christmas. And zu here takes dative. So, because Christmas, Diwali, these are festivals, proper nouns, it's okay if we don't say zum Weihnachten. Zu Weihnachten is fine. Zu Diwali is fine. But zum Geburtstag, because it's just one of the days, Tag. Okay, so schenken allen Verwandten ihre Lieblingssache. Now, this is what you call NAD sentence construction. Yeah, where you have a as your direct object and N as your subject. NAD sentence construction. Okay. So, nominative, NDA, I'm very sorry, it's NDA, by mistake I wrote it like this, okay, NDA sentence construction, because we discussed it in accusative, nominative, then accusative, and then that. Okay, so we have here NDA construction. This is going to be the positioning of objects in your sentence. Of course, now you can play with the sentence and say, mir gibt meine Mutter Schokolade, for example. Ja? Oder uns empfehlen die Lehrer einen interessanten Film. Einen interessanten Film empfehlen uns die Lehrer. Okay, so you can basically change the positioning and make the sentence more beautiful, or you can play with it and just take the advantage of this flexibility of German sentence. But of course, like we said, the verb will be at position two and the rest you can shift and make, like, experiment yourself. Okay, so nominative subject, but see, nominative and verb will go hand in hand always, either before verb or after verb. Meine Eltern und Großeltern schenken allen Verwandten. Now for me, for example, allen Verwandten is important in the sentence. Now can you imagine all of the relatives get gifts from them. Every year. So, allen Verwandten I'll take in the beginning. Allen Verwandten schenken meine Eltern und meine Großeltern ihre Lieblingssachen zu Weihnachten. Okay, so it really depends what is important, what is most important in your sentence. You can take it at position one and then make your sentence. But if you want to stick to the usual or the traditional sentence construction, then this is going to be the sequence. NDA, nominative, dative, accusative. Okay, nominative, dative, accusative. NDA. NDA. Okay, now let's give it a twist. Well, I'll copy once again the sentences. So these were our sentences. Meine Mutter gibt mir Schokolade. Die Lehrer empfehlen uns einen interessanten Film. Meine Eltern und meine Großeltern schenken allen Verwandten ihre Lieblingssachen zu Weihnachten. Okay, so now you can see, even by reading, you read per block. And then it automatically gives meaning to the sentence. It's very beautiful to know. Now, for example, we have already used something in the context, something previously. Let's say, meine Mutter ist sehr lieb. Sie gibt mir jeden Tag Schokolade. Meine Mutter ist sehr lieb. Yeah, my mother is very loving, very kind. Meine Mutter ist sehr lieb. Sie gibt mir jeden Tag Schokolade. Now, what am I doing here? Instead of meine Mutter, I'll just underline it, I'm using a personal pronoun. Oops. Sie. Meine Mutter, so sie, of course, you know that already. Mein Vater will be er. Das Kind will be es. So, meine Mutter ist sehr lieb. Sie gibt mir jeden Tag Schokolade. Now again, I'm replacing the subject with the subject personal pronoun. Okay, so I don't have to think. If this, of course, the subject is nominative, then personal pronoun will also be in nominative, right? Wir sind 20 Studenten in der Klasse und der Lehrer empfiehlt, die Lehrer empfehlen uns einen interessanten Film. Wir sind 20 Studenten in der Klasse. Die Lehrer empfehlen uns einen interessanten Film. Now what we are doing here? So, 20 Studenten is used as uns over here. Correct? Again, a personal pronoun. Now, alle Verwandten kommen zu uns zu Weihnachten. Meine Eltern und Großeltern schenken instead of allen Verwandten, now I will say ihnen, ihre Lieblingssachen zu Weihnachten. Alle Verwandten is nominative. Okay, now you see the difference. This is nominative because common in this sentence, alle Verwandten plays a nominative role. It's a subject of the sentence. But In the next sentence, schenken. It is changed to personal pronoun. My parents and my grandparents are gifting them or gift them every Christmas their favorite things. Okay, so again here I have used the personal pronoun. Dann. Wir sind 20 Studenten in der Klasse. Und unser Lehrer, oh, let's take the plural because we have taken plural in the next one. Unsere Lehrer haben gestern einen interessanten Film gesehen. Die Lehrer empfehlen uns now einen interessanten Film, the, to avoid this repetition from the previous sentence, again in the next sentence, I will use the personal pronoun for it. But when we use personal pronouns, two personal pronouns in one sentence, like uns is also a personal pronoun and ihm is also a personal pronoun, then we take the accusative personal pronoun before dative. Die Lehrer empfehlen ihn uns. Die Lehrer empfehlen ihn uns. Ihn heißt einen interessanten Film. Okay, again I'll use the colors. Ihn heißt einen interessanten Film und 20 Studenten is used as uns. So what happened here? Here now we had the nominative accusative construction. Okay, now here we have NAD construction. Nominative, blau, accusative, grün, dative, rot. Okay, the NAD sentence construction. Okay, I'll just bold it, make it bold and extra bold. So. So what we did here? In case of using the personal pronouns, we'll take personal accusative first and then dative. In case of using proper nouns, we will take like article and noun, then we will take dative first and accusative later. Okay. So. Ich warte eine Minute hier. Okay, so have you understood the difference between NDA and NAD constructions? So NDA, nominative, dative, accusative, when we are using objects with nouns, with article and noun, and NAD, nominative, accusative, dative, when we are using our objects as with their personal pronoun. So that's the difference, and do practice well for the sentence construction. Make your own sentences taking some of the verbs. Along with this, I'll be giving you some verbs which take both the cases, for example, every time or depends on the use of it. And then try to make your own sentences using those verbs. Good. Tschüss.